In June, the Constitutional Court ruled the Electoral Act unconstitutional for not making allowance for independent candidates at provincial and national levels. The Inclusive Society Institute, together with an expert panel led by In Transformation Initiative Director Rolf Meyer, is working on a series of proposals on changing the country's electoral system to allow for independent candidates at provincial and national levels. The proposals will be presented to the ruling African National Congress. Mali's opposition has said it will intensify anti-government protests starting today and culminate in a mass rally on Friday and Saturday. Representatives of the June 5th Movement, or M5, said they had stepped up protests against President Keita. The opposition has blamed the government for economic decline, alleged corruption and a long-running conflict. Regional efforts to bring an end to the crisis have failed, with the opposition refusing to compromise on their demand that the president resigns. China, repeatedly being accused of oppressing the Uyghur Muslims in Xinjiang province, has now allegedly built a public washroom at a site where the Tukul Mosque once stood in Atush in the province. The construction of the restroom comes days after authorities had razed two of three mosques there as part of a directive to destroy Muslim places of worship en masse that was launched in the late 2016, known as Mosque Rectification. George Orwell's evergreen book Animal Farm, well known as one of the Bibles of literary studies, yesterday marked 75 years after it was first published by British publishing company Penguin Books. It has been described by many book lovers as an epic piece of literature. The allegorical novella painted a perfect metaphor for the pseudo-equity, fairness and justice that characterize human existence, especially along the political and socio-economic lines, even till today. And now for a look at your financials for this morning.